Justice 40 is an initiative that was launched by the Biden administration at the end of January. And it's a government-wide initiative, so it applies to every department in the federal government. And the ultimate goal of Justice 40 is to ensure that 40% of the benefits from relevant federal investments accrue to underserved or underprivileged communities. So that's a departure from how we looked at environmental justice in the past. The executive order that established environmental justice as a federal priority was enacted in 1994. And that executive order focused on avoiding disproportionate adverse impacts, there's some government speak for you, on minority and low-income populations. So narrow both in terms of looking just at impacts and two specific classes of populations. What Justice 40 does is broaden the lens to introduce the consideration of benefits. So I consider it the next generation of environmental justice. In a way, it's environmental justice 2.0, right? So now we're thinking about impacts, and we're thinking about, now we're thinking about benefits, and we're thinking about that across a broad range of populations. And Justice 40 is being driven by the Office of Management and Budget, who is auditing every federal agency and working with the leads of those agencies to identify gaps in whether or not those agencies are achieving equitable outcomes. So in the Department of Transportation, obviously a lot of federal investment goes through the Department of Transportation, and the different modal administrations all have different challenges as to how to address Justice 40. So there are a number of tools that are being developed, such as an environmental justice scorecard, so that agencies will be tracked on their performance as to whether or not they deliver those benefits. And one of the big questions for everybody is the data, right? Because do we have the right data, and is it in a disaggregated enough format to measure benefits? So this is a tremendous opportunity for HNTB, both helping our clients think through how they can respond to the Justice 40 initiative, how they can make their projects more attractive for federal investment by incorporating equity, but also helping the federal government think about what are the methods and procedures and best practices regarding identifying and measuring benefits.